So here we are at the Cannes Yachting Festival, where there are hundreds of boats, but I'm particularly impressed with this new model, the Azimuth 77S. So what, you ask, is so special about it? Well, it's sporty, even if it is a fly. Lovely interiors. There are four cabins and four bathrooms. Three living areas outside. And three engines in the machine room. So let's not waste any time. Off we go. It's 77 foot long, so almost 24 meters, weighs 56 tons and has 2,700 horsepower. Different to other boats of its ilk, there are three engines instead of two. So I guess you'll be asking, why only two levers? Easy, they control the external motors, but when they are together in the same position, they activate the central engine for more power.
In questa maniera le manovre possono essere eseguite in modo tradizionale oppure in modo molto semplice.
Like this, maneuvers can be made traditionally or more simply by using the joystick. This boat, that's almost 24 meters, can be moored easily, even sideways. The machine room has three diesel units by Volvo, Penta, the D13 model at 900 horsepower each one. So let's hurry up and get out of Cannes port so we can try it out.
With this kind of propulsion comes the possibility for large inside space.
Here we've managed four cabins and four bathrooms, because the engines have been moved right to the furthest point at the stern, as well as the machine room, which too is right at the back of the boat. The bow is always underneath the horizon because the intruders are controlled automatically, so the axis is perfect, even in this initial phase of planing.
L'accelerazione è piuttosto brillante perché la barca è molto leggera, realizzata completamente in infusione.
Acceleration is pretty good because the boat is so light. It's an all-in-one, the hull and superstructure together. There are six propellers, two for each engine. The IPS propeller turned towards the bow, so they pull.
Siamo a 20 nodi e navighiamo in un comfort fantastico.
We're going 20 knots, sailing in total comfort. It's so silent, and we're consuming 250 litres an hour. Let's give it a bit more. One of the problems with triple propulsion could be an increase in noise, because there are three engines instead of two. But the sound meter says just a little over 60 dBA at 25 knots. Fantastic, but there's a reason why.
Ciascuno dei tre motori è più piccolo.
Each of the three engines is smaller than you'd use on a twin engine.
L'efficienza di questa propulsione si percepisce soprattutto alle.
You can really see how efficient it is when you're going about 25 knots. Petrol consumption is just over 300 liters.
Hanno lavorato molto su questa carena, l'hanno progettata, poi sono andati a provarla in vasca navale, quindi sono ritornati al computer.
They've worked a lot on the hull, designed it and then gone into a naval basin to test it, then back to the drawing board to make some changes to end up with a perfect solution.
È una carena a V, ma nel tratto.
It's a V-shaped hull, but in the end, at the stern where the keel is a tunnel, it opens up, which helps the water flow easier towards the central engine's propeller. And then the final part of the boat is clear and slightly raised so that the three engines are higher and give less resistance in the water.
Massimo regime di crociera dell'Azimuth 77.
Azimuth 77 SE's maximum cruising speed is 30 knots. But is that as fast as it can go?
Allora, dovete tenere presente che il modello che sto provando è una barca in assetto di crociera, cioè con.
Well, you need to take into account that this model I am trying out is fully laden down, fully furnished, full storeroom, full petrol tank, as well as water.
E quindi in questo momento abbiamo il massimo.
So we are right now at maximum weight possible, and we're going 33 knots. So with about a third of the load, we'd probably get to 34, 35 knots.
Hanno fatto una grande attenzione alla distribuzione dei pesi su questa imbarcazione. Il serbatoio, ad esempio, è strutturale.
They've paid a lot of attention to weight distribution here. For example, the petrol tank is structural and lies along the keel axis so that the variants in petrol don't influence the balance. And then the superstructure is very light and the antenna mast on the flybridge is carbon and weighs approximately 49 kilos.
Cosa più piacevole è la sensazione che si prova nel pilotare questa imbarcazione.
But the nicest thing is how you feel when you're driving the boat, both being at the helm and how quiet it is right here.
Pensate che è stata ottenuta non soltanto assemblando l'imbarcazione nel modo più corretto.
Just think that it's not because the boat has been put together perfectly, that is with great fixtures, but also because of the elastics that absorb the vibrations working on the hull. The rails are inclined so they don't interfere with the water. So don't make any noise, and at the stern the rails are inverted, so they literally hold onto the water when the boat is turning, so it's more precise direction-wise.
Insomma, una barca non è bella solo perché ha un...
Anyway, a boat isn't beautiful just because of the way it looks. A fascinating design, but also because the design of the hull and superstructure and the furnishings makes life more comfortable on board. Something in which Azimut, without a doubt, is market leader.
L'Azimut 77S vi offre parecchie possibilità di pilotaggio, anche...
Azimut 77 offers a lot of options for the pilot. Either here from the flying bridge or from the main bridge. Like opening the roof to feel as if you were in the open. It's a very versatile boat.
Al massimo abbiamo registrato un consumo di 490 litri ora, ma il vero vantaggio di questa imbarcazione...
At most we've seen 490 liters consumed an hour, but the true advantage to this boat is that we've measured petrol consumption at cruising speed, and it is 20% less than a boat of the same size, weight and speed.
Ora rientriamo in porto.
So now we're going back into the Cannes port, and we can have a look inside. It has a sporty look and feel, typical for the S collection of yachts, even if it is a flybridge. They've put in enormous side windows because the structure has been reinforced with Kevlar. The sea is reflecting like crystal, so you can't really see inside, but from inside, the outside looks clear and still. It's a unique boat because the upper bridge has a soft top, like it's open. There are three living areas. The one at the bow has a coffee table. On the fly, there's enough space to organize as you will. And at the stern, an electric top covers the launching area and sun deck. The mobile external kitchen has a fridge and a bar. At the stern, the big door opens the hangars, where you'll find two tenders. The holds have been studied in minute detail in order to assure that they are very easy to use. Interiors are by Carlo Galizzi, as usual, with his use of colour that makes it fresh and modern. There's shiny Zebrano wood with finely worked leather. Let's not forget that a boat is a work of art that comes from handiwork of artisans and technicians, without whom a yacht would just be a design. Here, the living area and cockpit work together without barriers. The French doors open two-thirds, and there's no interruption between the interior and exterior dunnage. The lunching area has a black satin glass table that seats eight. The sofas in the living room area seat eight too. 42-inch television comes out of the cabinet. And look at this important high-tech thing, the door. It pivots on the side to make it easier to maneuver. The kitchen is in the mezzanine and has all the appliances. There's natural light that comes from the ceiling, and there's a gallery under the floor. How can you not be happy in a captain's quarters like this? Beautiful finishings, double window, TV behind the mirror, tea for two, and a wardrobe. The bath is dark grey ceramic and forest brown marble. Bow, the VIP cabin comes with separate bathroom and dressing table. Ceiling height never goes below 2 meters. Then there are two double cabins, one with three bunks. The crew have two cabins with three bunks. I chose to look at the Azimut 77S because I was amazed by its sporty lines. But then I was intrigued by the triple engine. And during the test, I discovered that it goes very well. It's really quiet. Now I can really say this boat is great stuff.